Hey yo, it's your boy Los. Let's get it.
See, I believe in love cause it lived here. I read a book on it. 1 John and 1 Corinthians got me hooked on it. Listen, I ain't talking kisses and hugs, I'm talking about a blood that floods every crack and crevice and every impurity is sitting under the heavens and came to wash and clean me. Believe me, see, y'all think walking in love is easy? Now that sacrifice just thinking the father who neglected his son and in turn the son gave up his life. Now he's living in regret, so why? Thinking I wish I knew what he felt inside. When in this room to reminisce, I will let her on the nightstand opening up a cry. I said, Father, why did you leave me? You used to come to my soccer game screaming, good job. When I scored a goal, I said, I want to go pro. You said, follow your dreams, but a new job took you away from me. So now I'm taking myself. And he ripped up that letter because he couldn't take it. That picture, a mirror of himself. So he felt like a total failure. But then he looked at the Savior, thinking, no matter what happened to my son, his love never moves or wavers. And he said, Father, forgive me, for I am empty. Just take me to the cross and fill me with your love that's never ending, I believe.
Hey, yo. All right, so as you can see, we're talking about the homie Cody Paul. Cody Paul is a cool cat, man, I met back in Columbus, Georgia a few years back. Good dude, man. At the time when I met him, he was a part of, I don't know if he was a part of a group. Well, I guess he was a part of a group. I'm explaining to you why I say that. So I'm watching him and this young cat on the stage get busy, both of them destroying it. But in all honesty, Cody kind of stood out to me. It was obvious to me that He just loved what he was doing, which was rapping and talking about God. He was just like an energizer bunny, man. He was just everywhere on the stage and then just killing the mic at the same time. I was really impressed with him, really, really impressed. And so him and his homie, and then at the end it was done, I had made mention to someone that I want to talk to him outside, and I guess I came across like some executive from out of Atlanta or something like that, right? Because I say that because when I go outside to talk to him, Cody's still inside, but his homie comes outside, right? And boy, he says to me something that I ain't never told nobody, man. I was really shocked that he said this to me, man. He was like, yo, man, just so you... Sorry. He goes, yo, man, just so you know, man, we're not a group, man. We're not a team. We individual artists, you know what I'm saying? So, and I said, what? Said it again? Yeah, we're individual artists, man. We're not a group, not a team, man. Just, you know, we just a homie, man. We cool. And he goes, so I'm saying to say, you know, if, you know, you... You know, if you want just one of us, you know what I'm saying? It's cool, you know what I'm saying? You can just take one of us. You ain't got to take both of us together. You know what I'm saying? It's okay. And I sat there and I said to myself, I'm like, wait a minute. So the impression I got was you thought that if I'm going to take you. No. No, sir. If I do have a label, I'm trying to do something, I'm grabbing your man. That is what it is, because it's just something about, it's not just about his bars, it was just his body, his person was just oozed out hip hop, you know what I'm saying? Oozed out bars, and I was impressed. Anyways, so he comes out, listening to him about that, but he comes out, we're talking, and I just kind of slightly rebuked him, didn't mean to be disrespectful, but basically just told him and his man that, yo, although y'all are gifted, it just seems to me like you guys are more focused on yourselves than on Christ. You know, you just need to probably look into that, watch out for that. They didn't like that. We had some words back and forth, and ended up on a really, really bad note. And I was like, I was discouraged because I really came there to do good, to say, you know, say something positive to him. But I'm pretty sure, knowing me at that time, I came across disrespectful. But so we left on bad terms. I think we exchanged numbers though. But a year later, right? I'm driving throughout Atlanta. Phone rings, don't know the number. Answer the phone, and it's Cody. And he actually like, yo, I need to repent, man. Apologize to you. And he admits that he, you know, was wrong pretty much for how he addressed the issue. He understands now what I meant was that, yeah, it's all about Christ, not about bars, not about myself. It's about making much of Christ, not much about me. And he just wanted to repent and apologize to me for that. And I was like, man, that's really big of you, bro. And I was really impressed by that. Then I apologize, I believe, if I didn't, I'm doing it now, for just my way of addressing the situation. I was still, you know, I don't know. I'm pretty sure knowing me, I was mad disrespectful in my approach. And so, yes, we had that conversation there. And then we met up again. And I just saw the change in him. It was just beautiful. He was still single at the time. Then he got married. Now he has kids, has a degree. A man doing his thing. And I'm very proud of him. The growth is just beautiful to see in him. To really, and I can say that about him. I've watched his man go from a little kid, man, to just a great man of God doing his thing. I'm very, very proud of him. So he hit me up the other day and was like, yo, man, I dropped my album, man. I need you. I want you to check it out, man. Let me know what you think. And I got to tell you, man, point blank from the bottom of my heart, man, this is a whack album. No, I'm playing. I'm playing, homie. Nah, this is actually a dope, dope album, man. I'm very impressed. very impressed with the body of work you presented, man. I think you did a dope job on it, bro. Few things, you know, but that's just me. But overall, top to bottom, man, I'm very, very impressed with this album. So the album is called Back to Basics. So the first song comes in. It's an 8-song EP, and I think it's beautiful that it's an 8-song EP because I get the impression that it is, I don't want to say a taste test. I want to say it's a stunner. It's the kind of album that you get out and like a boxer would, when it swing at a person, he will hit him in the jaw. He will kind of stun him, right? Just to set him up for that okie doke. You know what I'm saying? So the stunner kind of just gets you ready for what's about to come. And then when it comes after that stunner is that knockout. And I feel like this here just a stunner kind of album. Just for, so he put time in it. Yeah, put money, whatever. But I feel like this was just a little something to get you ready, get you prepared. And I'm gonna knock you out with the next joint, right? And so album starts off track one where him and his people's in the studio talking about, you know, he's back and things are going great, blah blah blah. And he spits a dope one-liner just to get kind of you know, exercise, get the blood circulating and everything, and you know, comes across dope. I was like, wow, he's back. And then the second verse comes in, he kind of talks some more, and then he does another verse, and it just phenomenal. I think he did a great job on the intro. But the second song though is called Home. I like that song a lot because not necessarily just for what he said, but what the song represents. The song Home is, and then on the, so the song's called Home, but the chorus is as the world turns back to him. Now what he's talking about, I'm gonna explain it, what I gathered from it was basically there's three verses, and each verse talks about pretty much struggle, you know, people going through stuff, things ain't easy for people, and you know, but he's talking about how God can and will use your struggles and your lifestyles, the bad things in your life to turn you and shape you back to him, to show you and help you to realize and recognize that you are in need of a God who can change your life, and not just your life, but yet put you in on a spiritual path to him of love, grace, and mercy. And I love that. I love the fact that the song was speaking about basically, is life going bad for you? Great. Here's Christ. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I got. It's like, yo, I'm so glad your life is upside down right now. So now let me introduce you to Christ. Beautiful song, bro. And then the very next song is called I Don't Need You. Quick warning. Don't sing this song, the chorus of this song, to your wife. It's just being bad for you, but I did that, being funny, didn't go well, but it's cool. But a great song, basically talking about depression, anxiety, things like that. I don't need you in my life, you're not important. Gotta be honest with you though, the mixing on this song and the very next song was pretty bad, like really, really bad. The song goes, it's going, and then all of a sudden I don't know what happened. I thought my speaker blew or something, because the volume went from, for instance, volume 18 to like volume 13, like that. And I was like, wow, that's what's going on. It just wasn't a good look, you know what I'm saying? Not sure who did your mixing, bro, but that didn't fly too well. Another song that I really enjoyed on the album. Finding Love Again was, I think, the next song after that, after I Don't Need You. His wife, I think she's singing on the hook. And I think it gives the impression that he's speaking about finding love again by his wife, right? But actually, he's talking about falling in love with the Lord. You've been hurt, you've been battered, you've been bruised, you've gone through some bad things in your life. But man, there is a love out there that you're searching and seeking for that will never hurt you, and it's Christ. And I love that song. When I got from that, the very next song after that is talking about his wife. It's called Relaxing. And basically, man, because Cody's wife is black, and I want to hear, you know, this is something I would love to hear in a future album, and maybe happen on the fifth Sunday. If not, I want to hear that struggle of being white, married to a black lady. I want to hear that struggle. I want to hear how God has brought you guys through that, and what you've learned through that. If not a song, I just want to hear you talk about it. You know, so I think it's a beautiful thing that needs to be discussed, and I just would love to hear that. And I would love to hear in a song. I'd love to hear you talk about it well, but I'd love to hear in a song. And I wish he was in this song, but he didn't, though. But still, beautiful song talking about, you know, love my wife and my Nubian queen. I love that. Wakanda for life. Dope track, bro. After that, we get Chasing. Now, Chasing and Chasing is number 6. 7 is Feature. But Chasing is basically just rebuking, not rebuking, but just warning Kevin, like, yo, you're chasing money, you're chasing fame, chasing fortune, all these things here, man, and it's gonna amount to nothing. It's like the wind, you'll never catch it. You're chasing all these things to hope to fulfill you, to satisfy you, but they can't do that because they were never designed to do that. Never, it wasn't the intention of them to be there to do that. The only thing that you'll find fulfillment in is in Christ. That's it. That's where you find your joy, you find your peace, you find your happiness in Christ. And this song here is talking about that, like he's screaming out, stop chasing these worthless things. Seek Christ. You know what I'm saying? It's a beautiful song, man. But the song that touched me the most, man, was the 7th one. I'm gonna get that 1 second. So the song, last song on the album called Back to Basics, and basically just letting you know this is just an EP, man. Don't take it too personal. We got to get back to praying, back to fasting, back to holiness, man, back to seeking after the Lord. Just get back to what's genuine, what's right. But my song is called No Feature. I think it's either Feature or No Feature, I'm sorry, but I love it because it speaks about when we stand before the Lord on that day, we will stand by ourselves with nobody else. Now, you know, on a feature on an album, you know, you got, you know, like Carlos featuring, so you and somebody else. But he's warning us that no. On that day, it's just you. You will give an account for your life by yourself. And I love that. I love that reminder, that beautiful, beautiful reminder of one day we will stand before the Lord and give an account for our life. And so because of that, be mindful of what you say, what you do, how you live your life, because you want to stand before the Lord and give an account for that. I love that. Beautiful song, bro. Beautiful song. Beautiful album, man. Good job, fam. I'm really impressed. I think you did a great, great job. Very impressed. Very impressed. Kind of album. Cody's the kind of rapper where, like I said, you see hip hop oozing out of him. Hold on, real quick. Sorry about that. Cody's the kind of rapper, man, that you can just feel that he enjoys hip hop. Like, this is real to him. This is not a game to him. Like, he's the kind of guy, right, that I can see, like, mad at where things have turned as far as the hip-hop game is. Like, I bet I could see him sit down regularly, complaining and like, stomping his feet at the progression or degression of hip-hop. And I love that man for that, man. He just is a dope dude. Dope album, bro. I'm very proud of you, man. Good job. Thank you for this stunner, but I'm looking forward, man, to the knockout that's coming up next. You know what I'm saying? For real. Yeah. Do your thing, bro. Alright, y'all. This is the wife. Say hello, wife.
It's
the wife. Really? Did you really say that? Okay. Anyway, alright, y'all. Grace.